All right, in this video, we're going to go over solving absolute value equations, and we'll do four different kinds. We'll start with sort of an easier one like this, and then we'll work our way up. So the idea is that if you have an absolute value, what you're going to want to do is set the argument there, the expression on the inside of the absolute value equal to plus or minus that number. All right, so when we do that, we get 7x minus 4 equals negative 10, or 7x minus 4 equals positive 10, like that. Okay, so once we do this, we have two equations that we can solve pretty easily just using regular algebra. Right? So we would add 4 here, and that would leave us with 7x equals negative 6. Okay, dividing by 7, we get one solution at negative 6/7. And then solving this piece, right, we'll add 4 on both sides. So we get 7x equals 14. All right, and then dividing by 7 gives us our second solution here, x equals 2. Now you can go ahead and take those, plug it in, see that they really do solve the original. It's pretty clear that it does. But let's just go ahead and move on. We're going to do a little more complicated example next. Okay, so now you can see here we have an absolute value equation. We have an absolute value in the equation, but it's not isolated. So the first step in solving these things is to actually isolate the absolute value. Okay, so to do that, what we're going to do is use a little bit of algebra here. We'll go ahead and subtract 5 on both sides. And that'll leave us with negative absolute value 3x equals negative 12. Okay, now from here we have a negative in front of the absolute value. There's a couple ways to deal with that. We can either multiply both sides by negative 1, or in this case I'm just going to divide both sides by negative 1. And negative 1 divided by negative 1 cancel, leaving me with absolute value of 3x equals positive 12. Alright, so that's the first step. You have to isolate the absolute value. Once you get the absolute value isolated, then you set the argument equal to plus or minus that number. All right, so we get 3x equals negative 12, or 3x equals positive 12. Okay, dividing by 3 here, x then equals negative 4. And then dividing by 3 on that one, x could equal positive 4. And again, you can plug those back into the original and see that they really do work. Okay, now let's do another one. All right, so let's look at this one. This one says absolute value of x minus 3 equals x plus 1. So the absolute value is isolated, but now the difference is that it's equal to a quantity, not just a number. Well, the idea for solving this is the same. So whatever's inside the absolute value, we're going to set it equal to plus or minus that. In this particular case, we have x minus 3 equals the opposite of that quantity, x plus 1, so minus, or x minus 3 equals positive that quantity. Okay, so once we're here, we just do the algebra. We no longer have an absolute value, so we can just do regular algebra. So we have x minus 3 equals negative x minus 1, distributing the negative there, and then adding x, right, that'll give me 2x minus 3 equals negative 1. 2x equals, I'm going to add 3. 2x equals 2. And then x equals 1 after I divide by 2 will be the first solution that I get there. All right, and then over here we have x minus 3 equals x plus 1. Now when I subtract x like I did on the previous example, I'm left with, well, the x is add to 0, so I'm left with negative 3 equals 1. And so that's a false statement. And we know in math, when we get a false statement, this piece contributes no solution. So the only solution that we got out of this calculation is 1. And you can actually plug that in, see 1 minus 3 is negative 2, and absolute value equals 1 plus 1, which is 2. So 2 equals 2, it checks out. All right, let's do one more type of example you're going to run into. All right, so here we have an absolute value equals an absolute value. And sometimes that throws people off, but we're going to work it the same way. Basically, we're going to set this argument x minus 1 equal to plus or minus that argument. It it doesn't matter which way you do it, you'll get the same results. So in this particular case, I have x minus 5 equals the opposite here, so negative 2x minus 1, or the x minus 5 is going to equal positive, right, 2x minus 1. And then we can solve each one of these little quantities with regular algebra. So the first step here would be to, of course, distribute the negative. And we get x minus 5 equals negative 2x plus 1. Right? And then adding 2x to both sides. That'll leave us with 3x minus 5 equals 1. Adding 5, 3x equals 6, and then x equals 2. And you can actually plug that in and check to see if it works. Here, we have actually x minus 5 equals 2x minus 1. So we'll go ahead and subtract 2x. X minus 2x is negative x. So negative x minus 5 equals negative 1. Adding 5, negative x equals 4. And then multiplying and dividing by negative 1, x equals negative 4. Okay, so those are my two solutions when we had an absolute value equals an absolute value. Now, at the beginning of the video, I said there was four examples, but there's actually one more type. If you stick around, it'll be worth it. We'll do one more as a bonus question. Okay, so here it is. The difference is that we have the absolute value of x squared minus 5 equals 4. The difference is that we have a quadratic inside the absolute value. Okay, the steps for solving are going to be the same, but the algebra steps after we get out of the absolute value notation are going to be different. All right, so let's see what we have. We have x squared minus 5. Well, that's going to equal negative 4, or x squared minus 5 is going to equal positive 4, right? So that's the same theorem that we're using for the absolute value. Now, to solve this quadratic, there's a number of ways to go. Since there's no middle term x, I'm going to solve by extracting square roots. I think it'll be easiest if I just go ahead and add 5 to both sides here, and I get x squared equals 1. Alright, and then we'll take the square root of both sides. Don't forget, when you take the square root of both sides, you have a little plus or minus going on. So the square root of x squared, we get x equals plus or minus the square root of 1, which is just 1. Alright, so this piece gives me two solutions for that absolute value inequality. Now we'll go ahead and do the same thing here, adding 5. Well, that gives us a 9 on the right side, so we have x squared equals 9, all right, and then taking the square root of both sides, not forgetting the plus or minus again, of course, we have x equals plus or minus the square root of 9, which is 3. So you can see in this case, we had an absolute value with a quadratic in it, and when we did the steps, we came out to 4 answers. If we were to try those, they all work. Okay, so there you go. 5 different types of absolute value equations that you'll run into. So, good luck.